So originally this video was going to be one of those Patreon bonus content things, but two things happened. One, the actual build process got a little bit too elaborate, and it was decided that the thing in the video would actually make a good charity auction item. And two, I got contacted by people who wanted to give me a little bit of sponsorship. So instead of just being like a random little addendum for my Patreons, you guys get to enjoy it, and hopefully we'll raise some money for charity too. But in the meantime,
introducing Raid Shadow Legends, the game that's already a smash hit, a phenomenon, a blockbuster, a whole bunch of other words from the old thesaurus.
Raid Shadow Legends is a brand new collection RPG game taking the mobile gaming world by storm. Over 10 million players have downloaded the game in just 6 months.
Get real, raw, dark, epic and awesome. Raid Shadow Legends will transport you to a realistic world of dark fantasy.
Raid has a fully voiced story campaign, is totally free to play and has over 400 champions for you to collect. Check out the level of detail on these guys. What I like about this game is that it has something for everyone. Some people like collecting the characters, other people like the deep storyline and graphics. Personally, I think it's neat that you can fight other real-life players.
But you don't have to take my word for it. With over 300,000 reviews, Raid has almost a perfect score at the Play Store.
The game is growing super fast. Check out this cool roadmap they've published. They have huge plans for updates over the next 6 months. So there's infinite content and zero possibility of you getting bored. They have plans for a new faction, a new tag team arena feature, even a new clan boss. You'll be able to fight with your clanmates.
So what are you waiting for? Go to the video description, click the special links, and get 50,000 silver and a free epic champion to start your journey with as part of the new player program. Good luck! Now, because of certain videos that I'm making as we speak, kind of thing, I've decided it would be funny if I had a outfit to go along with the sword, but instead of, I think He-Man, he wears like a big Teutonic cross thing here, and I thought it would be funnier to have like the He-Man getup, but instead have a metal plate with the Michael Cthulhu symbol on it. Although it has to be smaller than my t-shirt version. You can imagine if this was on a steel plate, it would cover up most of my chest. Whereas the He-Man thing is always kind of like a square that sits here with... Anyway, it has to be smaller. So, while I'm busy making the sword, I'm going to get Evan to start cutting up these. And then I will jump back in when it's welding it all together and doing all the other costuming bits. O'clock. So even though this guy was welded from the back, yeah, because this material was so thin, the material of the symbol was so thin, there was so much bleed through on this side. It was easier to drop extra material on this side and all the bleed through points, and then I'll grind that away. I can't tell from the viewfinder which way is way up, but yeah, it bent like a banana. So I'm gonna have to bend it back. Yow, yow, yow. So after welding the pieces on, I was kind of fishing around for paint, and I found this old paint in a can, and I was like, I'll try this. It was a complete disaster. It was all too gloopy and way too thick and stuff, but it kind of works. Like, I don't know, can you tell that it's not... It didn't cover it properly, and I had to use paint thinners on it, and it's more like it's stained
the rusty piece of metal rather than painting it. But I think it, you know, I think it kind of gives it kind of a battered, battle damaged kind of look. So I might just leave it, you know. When I was looking for the red paint, I found this stuff, which is like, it says copper on it, but it also says gold leaf. It's good, but it still looks like paint. If I had not painted it, I could have, I don't know, shined up a pair of pennies and stuck them in here. Are pennies still made of copper? Probably made of zinc these days. Spanish, Spanish, Spanish. Spanish, Spanish, Spanish. Doesn't say how long it takes to dry. I'll check back on it later. These are the yellow boots, or the rather were yellow boots I used for the banana slug costume I had a couple of years ago. So these strips, I have a manky old sheepskin rug which I actually dug out of the basement where we had it, and I was like, oh, it doesn't look that bad, but then when I started to interact with it, I was like, oh god, it's manky. Like when I cut these strips out, all this stuff came out. I mean, it was only kind of dusty stuff, but it was kind of gross. And then I actually cut one of the strips too short because I didn't notice the edges were all like moth-eaten and had to shorten them. So I'm going to glue these around the top of the boot. I might only do it a little bit at a time because this hot glue gun, I noticed it comes down very quick once it's out of the gun. They look like weird Santa boots. I guess any fur top boot is going to look like a weird Santa boot no matter what you do. Number two will be the same thing. I don't need to record that twice. That's my kettle boiled. You know, I didn't actually check these guys for anything arachnid before I dug these guys out of storage, so hopefully there's nothing creepy crawly in the bottom of them. Yeah, so I think these are okay crappy He-Man boots. Well, I gotta make the furry underpants real quick before stuff starts to get too weird around here. I thought I was recording the first part, but maybe I wasn't. I cut out this by just holding it up to me. And I'm going to cut across here. In order to see now whether or not that fits me, things around here have to get nudie. I might tune back in when I have done the fitting. Furry underpants, la la la. Furry underpants, la la la. Okay. This is normal. This is an okay thing to put on YouTube. It has a goldy belt on it as well, so I have to make that now. That frame took a long time to put on, and it's kind of hard to see. It's because the cardboard I used wasn't particularly thick. Just to make it pop a little bit more. Oh boy, that's a lot of fumes. Is this too many fumes? Is it making me feel sick? I might be getting sick. Okay, cool. I'm gonna stick something on the back. Piece of elastic to make it stick.
These are the little gauntlet things I used for the Red Sonja photo shoot. But they still work, and they're about the same size as He-Man's bracers. So, recycling. These probably won't even be visible. It's just, they were already here, and it's either like throw them out or stick them back on. Ah, yes. Now this should be sent directly to our cursed images. I noticed when I was wearing it, the front panel of the underpants, they had kind of a pot, like a baggy bit, like it would this part at the front would stick out, because you know this is sheepskin, so it's not like form fitting or anything. This is just a bent paper clip I'm using to feed the elasticated string through the holes. Yeah, so then if I tighten this up, it's kind of a nice little hammock shape at the front. I need your help making this thing. They're relatively hard to do on yourself. Step one, is this running down the middle of my head?
Yes, in the front. I can't really see. I guess in the rear view it looks. Whoa! Turn. Stay there. Face forward at me. That's in the middle of the front. Yes.
Okay, so I need you to mark where they are this away, and then the imaginary lines where they are underneath.
Okay.
We have to do this three times.
Do you want a scissors or a kniff? Yeah.
As long as it's in the correct position.
You'll see that one of the lines isn't very good, but I can't get it good because...
Can you grab the corners and spread the bottom out?
Mm-hmm.
No. It doesn't matter so much. What matters is... So the He-Man hair... I guess it's just where these cardboard things start. Yeah, I'll have a look at a picture, but that should be it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So I had a more elaborate plan. This works, this will be faster. This could be about to end in disaster. This is getting heavy. Is it sticky? It is, but it takes a second for it to get sticky. Oh man, it was so close. So stupid as that looks, I think that's going to work, provided I can get a second can of that stuff. I'd originally planned to build up stuff which is cardboard and tape, but the more I looked at it, the more I was like, no matter what I do, it's going to look like a weird papercraft thing. But I think I can make something very organic looking if this, provided this stuff sets, and I can attack it with a sander. Would I do a crazy experiment? Version of the stuff that's not fully set responds to shaping. Okay, so I think it's going to work, but I have to wait till I have to get another can and wait till it goes hard. Yes, this was a good idea I had. What I think I'm going to do though, before I spray on the additional material that I need, is I'm going to grind it first to see how weird it is underneath the surface. Is there a whole bunch of like holes and cavities and things, and then depending on how that goes, I'll then spray in the additional material. This is a warm insulating hat. This will help the heat exhaustion when using the sword, I'm sure. Boy, dust everywhere. So it's filled with little cavities, but I'm not sure it matters, because it still registers as a solid-ish surface.
So I don't think it matters that much that it's filled with cavities. Still though, I'm going to put on that second layer now.
Now, it's stuck to the cardboard really well, so hopefully it sticks to its old self really well too, but there's a fringe in here that I'm trying to dig out. The expanding foam, it sure does expand. Cavity of stuff that hasn't set in the middle here. Okay, I think I've carved it with the hacksaw enough that I can start in with the grinder. Not looking forward to getting covered in dust. Okay, I think that's good enough for comedy purposes. It's making a weird noise, like a little Rice Krispie noise. I hope I haven't set off like some sort of weird chemical reaction between the expanding foam and the paint. Am I going to come back in a couple of hours to find that this has melted? Hope not. I'm in Marie's workshop. I haven't been here in a while, and she got leather for the backing plate because I don't even know that I film it, but I tried to recycle stuff out of an old leather jacket I had, but it was too old. It all fell apart and stuff. So Marie has nice new stuff, so that's what we're going to use. So you're just thinning the end of it so it folds over easier.
Yeah, so it's not so thick once it gets folded over.
Thing you were showing me. It is actual, it takes out a rectangular section, it doesn't just punch through it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because if you're just cutting a slit, then that makes this flail.
Yeah.
Makes it too wide right there. Alright, so then you just try it. I want that to have enough glue in there. Have like a hole in the back of it. I always buy the double caps because I like it to look nice on both sides. See, wouldn't that be so much cooler if I had like an anvil that was just a pounder, right?
Yeah. No, a little tiny bit of railroad track I think would be the thing. I know the one in the show was grey leather, but Marie didn't have grey leather, so... Besides, this isn't quite a He-Man harness. It's a Michael Cthulhu harness. There's the thing, god damn it. That's all of these little plates on. This took longer to do than this did. So there is weird holes out of it. So I think the paint did dissolve it a little bit. See, there's something there, like there's a weird look. So I think if you were painting it again, if I was doing this again, I might use acrylic spray paint or maybe just even hand painted, although that might be a pain in the butt on this surface. But yeah. But it's still yellow, and it's still more or less the shape it was, so I think I'm still going to go with that. If anything, it's a little bit funnier looking because it's gross. Actually, I took my hair up inside. Oh! Too much hair!
Is that uneven? There we go. I feel like fabulous powers have been revealed to me.
I also feel a bit like Sean Connery in Zardoz. In order to have a proper He-Man outfit, though, there's an extra thing you need. Some extra unspecified thing. And this is where, like, a card that would appear... Actually, I'm not sure which side it would appear. That would link to the He-Man sword build I'm doing. Would appear... Who knows? You might be watching this in the future, and cards linking to other videos might no longer be a thing, so that joke will make no sense. So, as mentioned before, this is charity auction. I'm not auctioning off the entire outfit, because the entire outfit is made of garbage, but the plate is pretty cool looking, and it has real leather straps and stuff, so that's what we're auctioning off. If you would like to buy a Michael Cthulhu chest plate and make the world a little bit less awful, there'll be details in the video description how to do that. Might have some of my chest hairs embedded in it too. I don't know how to size it. You have to be pretty close to my size for it to fit, but I'm an old fat guy, so it'd probably be okay. So here, we'll get a nice shot for the thumbnail. Okay, that's it.